Alright. Hello, good morning everyone. Sa lahat po ng ating mga taga-subaybay, sa lahat po ng mga kasama natin sa Bible study. Alright, so itutuloy po natin ang ating study sa Book of Romans. Romans chapter number 7. So, natapos po natin ang 6 chapters and we are now going to start another chapter. And this is chapter number 7. Okay? So, sa lahat po ng kabubukas lamang kanilang Facebook, magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Brother Mayna and Sister Raquel, good morning sa inyo. Okay po, so we're going to start with a short prayer. Tayo po ay manalangin. Our Father in Heaven, once again, we thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity to teach the Bible. And thank you, Lord, for some listeners. We are so blessed with the many studies that we had. And we thank you, Lord God, for the wisdom that you gave us and also the opportunity, Lord God, to open the Bible with liberty. Study the Bible with liberty. And, oh God, thank you, Lord, for some people who taught us the Bible. That's the reason why we are able to teach others also. Bless us, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so good morning po. At tayo po ngayon ay nasa chapter 7. Hopefully, hindi po nyo nakakalimutan yung mga studies natin sa Book of Romans, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, 5, 6, no? 7. Ngayon na po, 7 na po ito. Okay? So, let's read verse number 1 as we start. Okay? Romans chapter 7, verse number 1. The law on marriage. Verse 1 to verse 3. Know ye not, brethren, for I speak to them that know the law, how that the law hath dominion over a man as long as he liveth. For the woman which hath an husband is bound by the law to her husband so long as she liveth. But if the husband is dead, she is loosed from the law of her husband. So ito po yung law wherein kapag ang isang partner, okay, ay kinuha na ng Panginoon or dead, no? Yung pong naiwan is already free to marry again. Okay? The Bible said, know ye not, brethren, for I speak to them that know the law, how that the law hath dominion over a man as long as he liveth. So habang po silang dalawa ay mag-asawa, okay, ay buhay, no? Wala po silang, you know, batas na magbibigay po sa kanila para po sila po ay sabihin natin yung isa ay mag-asawa. But we're dealing with three ways na ang tao po ay pwedeng magkaroon ng chance to remarry again. But we're not going to discuss that. Didiscuss lang po natin yung isa, no? Yung maliwanag na kapag ang isang tao po ay naging free na dahil po ang isa po ay namatay, now that man or woman can marry again, no? Wala na siya, wala nang boundary o wala, ibig sabihin, hindi na siya bound ng batas. Okay, yun ang sinasabi ng 7 verse 1 and verse 2. Okay? The Bible said, know ye not, brethren, for I speak to them that know the law, how that the law hath dominion over a man as long as he liveth. For the woman which hath an husband is bound by the law to her husband so long as he liveth. So long as he liveth. Habang buhay pa. But if the husband be dead, she is loose from the law of her husband. She is loose from the law of her husband. Ibig sabihin, binigyan na siya ng laya sapagkat wala na pong okay, hindi na po siya magta-transgress ng anumang batas. Okay? Now, you go to verse 3. Then, if while her husband liveth, ito po yung isang babae na ang kanyang asawa ay buhay pa. Okay? She be married to another man. Kung buhay pa po ang kanyang asawa, she be married to another man, she shall be called an adulteress. But if her husband be dead, she is free from the law, from that law, so that she is no adulteress, though she be married to another man. Okay? So, ang isang babae na sinasabing as an illustration sa verse 3, Ito po yung isang babaeng she is stepping out on her husband while they are still legally married. Huh? That is why she is called an adulteress. Kaya tinawag po siyang adulteress. The word married is what throws all the apostates in a panic, where they think that a marriage is a ceremony. So marriage is not a ceremony. No? Okay, when God put away His wife, He said, "She is not my wife." And if that were not clear enough, that He added, "Neither am I her husband." Sabi ng Hosea chapter 2 verse 2. So God, okay, sabi ng Bible doon sa verse 3, wala pong binanggit po dyan na divorce. Alright? Walang binanggit na divorce dyan. So that is a woman stepping out on her husband while they are still legally married. No? That is why she's called adulteress. Legally married. Alright? Tapos nag-asawa ng isa pa, and that is called adultery. Alright? Okay, so wala pong discussion ng divorce po dito. Ha? So, punta lang po tayo doon sa basic muna. Yung basic na kapag ang dalawa ay buhay pa, at pagkatapos po, ang isa po, while they are legally married, ang isa po ay nag-asawa. No? While legally married, nag-asawa ng isa, then ang tawag po doon ay adultery. Alright? Sa babae, no? Sa babae, that's adultery. Okay? Now, verse number 4, let's move to verse number 4. That is the law on marriage. Okay? Verse number 4. Wherefore, my brethren, this is the believer's relationship to the law. The believer's relationship to the law. Ngayong ligtas na tayo, ano ang relasyon natin sa law? Because alam natin, sa Old Testament, ang umiiral doon yung law. Yeah, di ba? Moses was given the law. Alright? At ang umiiral sa Old Testament is the law. How about in the New Testament? Yung mga saints, yung mga believers sa New Testament. What is their relationship to the law? Okay, basahin po natin verse number 4 up to verse number 6. Wherefore, my brethren, ye also are become dead to the law by the body of Christ, that ye should be married to another, even to him who is raised from the dead, that we should bring forth fruit unto God. For when we were in the flesh, the motions of sins, which were by the law, did work in our members to bring forth fruit unto death. But now we are delivered from the law, that being dead, wherein we were held, that we should serve in newness of spirit, and not in the oldness of the letter. So, dapat maintindihan muna natin yung law on marriage. Bago po natin ma-interpret ano ang relationship ng isang believer sa law. Okay? Sabi ng law of marriage, kapag ang isa, okay, sa mag-asawa ay namatay, then free na siya para mag-asawa ulit. Now, that is the basis para po maintindihan natin yung ating relationship sa law ngayon. Sa law. Okay, now, verse 4, when Paul applies verse 1 to 3, the Christian's body represents the husband. The Christian's body represents the husband. So, gagamitin po natin yung law of marriage sa verse 1 to 3. The Christian's body represents the husband. And the Christian's soul, yung kaluluwa, represents the husband's wife. So, naintindihan po natin. So, yung relationship natin sa law is like this. The Christian's body represents the husband. And the Christian soul represents the husband's wife. Okay. Before salvation, the soul cleaves to the body. So we have to understand this. Na meron pong tinatawag nilang spiritual circumcision. That is the separation of the soul and the body. Alright? Ang operation ay ginawa ng Holy Spirit sa atin when we got saved. Hopefully you understand that. Okay. Before salvation, the soul cleaves to the body. They are intact. Okay? Walang separation ng soul and body. So that's the reason why in the Old Testament, kung anong hawakan ng body, affected ang soul. Okay? Pag unclean ang kanyang nahawakan, Sabi ng Old Testament, unclean ang kanyang soul, alright? Because there is no circumcision of the body and soul happened yet. Okay, pag ang salvation nangyari sa atin, our soul and our body is what? Separated. Ang tawag po doon, spiritual circumcision, that is in Colossians chapter 2, verse 11 to 12. Alright? So, nag-separate ngayon yung soul and body. Alright? Now, if this is the body, this represents the husband. If this is the soul, it represents the husband's wife. Ito yung wife. Okay? Alright? Okay. Pag-aralan natin mabuti. Before salvation, the soul clips to the body and both are one flesh. One flesh sila. Ephesians 5, verse 31. Parang yung married man and woman, one flesh sila. They are united to each other. Christ's death for sins did away with the Christian's body so that the soul can marry Jesus Christ. That is made possible by spiritual circumcision. Okay? Balik po tayo sa Romans 6:2. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? We are dead to sin. Okay, bakit po nangyari ganun? Because after we got saved, this body is what? Called dead. Tandaan natin, nung tayo hindi pa saved, anong meron tayo? We have a living body, a living soul, and what? A dead spirit. Pero after we got saved, okay, we have now a living spirit, a living soul, and what? A dead body. See that? Okay. Now, since the body is dead, parang yung husband, pag namatay na siya, so yung babae, yung soul, okay, ito, body soul, ha? Itong body, alright, dahil nag-asawa na siya, ay dahil mag-asawa sila, hindi pa pwedeng ikasal yung babae sa ibang lalaki. So what happened? Nung tayo na saved, this body is reckoned dead. Okay? And this soul, alright? This soul, okay? This soul, diba? Parang yung wife can remarry again. That's the reason why pwede na niyang i-marry si Jesus Christ. Okay? So, united na tayo kay Christ ngayon. Because the body is reckoned as dead. So, our soul now marries the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, that's the only way that we can be married to Christ. First, we must be circumcised, okay, with the spiritual circumcision, and the body is dead, and the soul is alive, but can remarry again, and a marriage with Jesus Christ is now possible. Alright, so nakita po ninyo, the body is dead, the soul, okay, the soul can remarry again and marry the Lord Jesus Christ. So, yun pong sinasabi ng Romans chapter 7. Kung bakit ginamit po yung Romans 7 verse 1 to 3 about the law of marriage. Kasi ko, ang relationship natin sa Panginoon is like marrying the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? So, we are now united, okay, to the Lord Jesus Christ. So, that's the possibility na nangyari po because of what? Of the circumcision. Okay, so, let's continue. Verse 5, so for when we were in the flesh, the motions of sins, which were by the law, did work in our members to bring forth fruit unto death. But now we are delivered from the law, okay, yung pong parang mag-asawa kanina, that being dead wherein we were held, that we should serve in newness of spirit and not in the oldness of the letter. So we are now what? Separated with our body. So we can marry the Lord Jesus Christ. You see that? Okay? Alright. So now we can serve, sabi ng Bible, in the newness of spirit and not in the oldness of the letter. Okay? Yun po yung law. Yung law. Ha? So ngayon, kaya kapag ang tao po yung nagkakasala, the soul, okay, is not affected because the soul is separated from the body. The body now might sin, okay, because the flesh nagdudwell dyan ng sin eh. The body now might sin, but it will never affect the soul because the soul is already married to Jesus Christ. Alright? Okay, now, verse 7, the purpose of the law. So, yung una po kanina is the law on marriage. Now, pangalawa po, the believer's relationship to the law. Now, this is the purpose of the law. verse 7 up to verse 12. What shall we say then? Is the law sin? God forbid. Nay, I had not known sin, but by the law, for I had not known lust, except the law had said, thou shalt not covet. Okay, so anong purpose ng law? Ang purpose po ng law ay para siyang mirror. Okay? Ito ka, no? Ikaw, ito. Titingin ka sa salamin, di ba? Okay, sabi nga ng iba, ang pinakamalaking problema ng tao ay kapag umarap na siya sa salamin. Okay? So, ito yung salamin. Alright? Ito yung tao. Whenever he face, what? The mirror, anong nakikita niya? Yung kanyang itsura. Right? Okay. So, the mirror shows what is in the person. Okay? So, this is the law. Ito yung law. Ito yung kautusan. This is the mirror. Ito yung kautusan. Now, if a person looks on the law, when a person looks on the mirror, then makikita po niya kung ano ang kanyang nagagawang kasalanan. So, that is the purpose of the law. Okay? Now, so the law will tell us that we are sinner. But sin, verse 8, taking occasion by the commandment, wrought in me all manner of concupiscence, for without the law, sin was dead. Tama, no? Without the law, ibig sabihin, asan yung kasalanan? Walang law. Okay? So if there is no law, there is no sin. Sin is only present, okay, when there is law. Naalala nyo sa Genesis 3? Genesis 3, may law ang Diyos. Nilagay sa, binagay dyan sa chapter 2. Dahil may law, okay, ang nangyari, nung ginawa ni Adan at ni Eva, yung pagkain sa pinagbawal ng Diyos, so they what? Transgress the law. So pumasok po ang kasalanan because there is transgression of the law. When there is no law, there is no sin. Okay, sinasabi ng Bible dito. So what is now the purpose of the law to us Christians? Ito ang nagsasabi sa atin that we are what? We are sinner. Okay? We have sinned against God. Alright, verse number 9. For I was alive without the law once, but when the commandment came, sin revived, and I died. So that is the effect of law. The effect of law will tell you that you are a sinner, and you are dead. Okay, you are dead. Dead what? You are separated to God. Okay, kaya nga po, merong tatlong klaseng death sa Bible. The physical death, nagawa din ng kasalanan nito. Bunga din ng kasalanan nito. The spiritual death, ito na may separation natin sa Diyos because we are spiritually dead. Alright? Kapag hindi nagamot ang spiritual death, ano mangyari? Ang ending po nito, ano? Second death, and that is hell. Alright? So, sin caused us to die. Death is a separation. So, kaya po, balang araw, yung soul will be separated from your body. Your soul will go to heaven, your body will go to the grave. Separation of body, soul. And you are now, if you are not saved, listen, sa lahat po nakikinig, if you are not yet saved, you are separated from your what? From your God. Okay? So, wala ka relasyon sa Kanya. Now, let's go back to verse 9. For I was alive without the law once, but when the commandment came, sin revived, and I died. And the commandment which I was, and which was ordained to life, I found to be unto death. For sin taking occasion by the commandment, deceived me, and by it slew me. Wherefore the law is holy, and the commandment holy, and just, and good. So there is no problem with the law. The problem is that it's a person. Okay? It's not the law. Because the law is what? Holy, and the commandment is holy, and just, and good. So walang problem sa law. Ang problem is that tayo na nag-obey dun sa law. Okay? Now, tindahan po natin. If God, you're going to use the law as a basis of salvation in our time, nobody can pass. Wala pong makakapasa sa batas. Bakit po? Lahat po nagkasala eh. Sabi ng declaration ng Romans 3:23. That's the reason why salvation in our time is not by the law, it is by grace. That's the reason why Christ died on the cross, because we are sinners, at kapag ginamit ng Diyos ang kanyang batas, nobody can be saved. we are short of the glory of God. So it's grace that saves us. It is not the law. Ngayon, ang law ang nagsasabi sa ating we are sinner. Every time we face the mirror will tell us there's problem in our face, there's problem in our body. Every time we face the Bible, we face the law, it tells us that we are sinner. Okay? Now, so verse number 9, the verse has to be reconciled with Ephesians 2 verse 1 to 3. For no man is alive spiritually without the law. So everyone is born dead. Paul plainly means that sin is not imputed to a man when he is a child. Romans 4 verse 15. When a child finally gains the knowledge between good and evil, according to Deuteronomy 1:39, sin and death that goes along with it are attributed to him. For then on, a man needs the new birth. So kapag ang isang tao po, okay? Kapag ang isang bata, no, bata, yung bata, no, wala siyang knowledge between good and evil, wala po siyang imputation ng kasalanan, tandaan po ninyo. Although may law na magsasabi po na ang isang tao ay makasalanan, since a man, alright, or a child has no knowledge of good and evil, then siya po ay absuelto sa parusa ng kasalanan. That's the reason why ang mga bata, okay, sin is not imputed to a man when he is a child, Romans 4:15. Kaya ang mga bata po, kapag sila po'y namatay nang wala pong knowledge between good and evil, they go straight to heaven. Okay, so hindi mo na po sila kailangang binyagan para sila'y maging Kristiyano. No? So yun ang problema po ng marami, because we thought that kapag tayo po ay hindi na binyagan, nung tayo bata pa, pupunta tayo sa limbo. Okay, so invented po yan ng mga Roman Catholic Church na yung lugar ng limbo para sa mga bata at magiging tiyanak sila doon. No, that's all invention. Okay, there is no scriptural basis for that. Kapag ang bata hindi na binyagan, kaya nga po kayong mga Baptist, ha, hindi po nyo dapat equate ang binyag sa dedication. Ang dedication po ay hindi binyag. Ang binyag po, yun ang Roman Catholic belief. Kapag ang binyag po, ha, sabi natin, kailangan binyagan pa lang bata kasi baka mamaya yung original sin nasa kanya pa, no? I tell you, wala pong ganun sa Bible. Baptism will not save you. Baptism will not regenerate you. Okay? So, huwag kang pupunta doon sa isang relihiyon na naniniwala na ang bata kapag hindi na binyagan, diretso sa limbo. Okay? That's another invention. That's another blasphemy in the sight of God. Okay? Kaya nga po tayong mga Baptist, umalis tayo sa maling paniniwala na yon, sapagkat wala po itong katotohanan. So, binalot lang po tayo sa takot ng matagal na panahon. For almost 400 years na, na binabalot tayo ng paniniwala ng Roman Catholic Church na wala namang katotohanan. Kaya nga po, ipag-pray natin ang mga mahal natin sa buhay na nandyan pa sa relihiyong yan, because those people are blind. Okay? Blind. Okay, now, balik po tayo sa ating pinag-aralan. We go to verse 13 up to verse 25. Dito po, maganda po itong discussion na ito. Huwag po kayong bibitaw. No, malapit na tayong matapos. Two natures. Ang pag-usapan po natin, two natures. Huwag po kayong bibitaw. Napakaganda po na pag-aralan natin. Verse 13 up to verse 25. I will read first and then we're going to expose it. What was then that which is good made death unto me? God forbid. But sin, that it might appear sin, working death in me by that which is good, that sin by the commandment might become exceeding sinful. For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal, sold under sin. For that which I do, I allow not; for what I would, that do I not; but what I hate, that do I. Right? Now, ito pong mga katagang ito ay sinasabi ng isang taong saved na, ha? Saved. Nagkaroon na siya ng new birth. Nagkaroon na siya ng regeneration. Siya ay child of God. Okay. Ito ay sinasabi ng isang tao na papunta na ng heaven, ligtas, secured. Pero ang sabi po niya ganito, verse 16, if then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that it is good. So there is no problem with the law. If we disobey, if we sin as a Christian, there is no problem with the law. The problem is what? Inside of us. Look at verse number 17. Now then, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. So that is only possible if there is a spiritual circumcision happened to you. Your soul and your body separated. Okay, sabi ni Paul, now then it is no more I that do it. It is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. So asa nagdudwela kasalanan? Doon sa body, hindi doon sa soul. Right? The soul is eternally saved, but the body can commit sin, I tell you, while the soul is sure going to heaven. Okay? For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing, for to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find that. That's the problem. In our dual nature, there is a problem. It is hard for us, okay, to obey the law because this sin, all right, the body, as the sin lives in our body. That's a problem. We struggle tayo sa pagsunod natin sa Diyos. May struggle. We are good, and then next time we are bad. We are bad, next time we go back to good, to be good. And then we good, we are good now. Alright, spiritual, mga ilang minuto lang, makakamali tayo, nakakagawa tayo ng kasalanan. Now, this flesh is really bound to sin. This is the capital of the devil. Dito siya kumukuha ng kapital. Yung kahinaan ng ating flesh. That's the reason why magpapakita siya ng mga evil things, magpaparinig siya ng mga evil things, magpapaisip siya ng mga evil things, pagagalawin niya yung katawan natin sa pamagitan ng mga music, and that means that the body will be used for unrighteousness while the soul is saved. Kaya pag tinanong mo sa akin, Pastor, bakit may mga Kristiyanong gumagawa ng ganon, nakasalanan, I tell you, kung ilalagay natin, mga kapatid, ang mga Kristiyano sa isang parang instrument, nadadaan sila parang doon sa mga immigration, sa mga airport. Okay? Dadaan sila doon sa isang lugar na kung saan magbi-blink. Alright? Kapag merong na-sign na, o merong ang metal, o everything. Kapag nagkaroon tayo ng instrument na ganon, para ma-detect ang sin, I tell you, lahat ng Kristiyanong dadaan doon, magbi-blink lahat, magsasound. Bakit po? Sapagat sa kanila ay nasa kanila ang kasalanan. Baka yung iba, hindi lang isang blink. Baka marami pang blink. Blink, 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 blink. Why? You know why? Because we are sinning against God while we are saved. That is written in the Bible. Okay? Verse number 18. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present with me. But how to perform that which is good, I find not. Kaya nga po sa judgment seat of Christ, may sinabi doon that what we have done in our body, whether it be good or bad. Now, for the good that I will do not, but the evil which I would not, that I do. So that is the true nature. Alright? Now, if I do that, I would not, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. The sin that dwelleth in me. Alright? So, sa verse 17, the verse is a perfect illustration of the two natures in a Christian and provides the Pauline explanation of 1 John 3:9. Kasi yung sa 1 John 3:9, merong seed doon na hindi na nagkakasala. Ano yung seed na yon? Sa 1 John 3:9, that is the soul. Alright? Yung seed po sa 1 John 3:9, that is the soul. Okay? Now, the real Christian that cannot sin is the new man. Yung totoong Christian na hindi nagkakasala, yun yung new man, yun ay si Christ na nasa atin. Which lives in a body of what? Death. That is the old man. Verse 24. Okay? So, naintindihan na po natin. Ang hindi nagkakasala sa atin ay yung new man. Tandaan natin yung spiritual circumcision. This is the body. This is the soul. So, na-separate yung body and soul. Ano yung hindi nagkakasala dyan? Yung soul. But yung old man, ito yung new man. But yung old man, yun ay nakakasala pa rin. Okay? Hope you understand that. Okay, in verse 18, this is the genuine Christian's spiritual response to his flesh. The genuine, okay, Christian's spiritual response to his flesh. Verse number 18. Okay. In contrast to this verse, is a classic modern blasphemy. Modern blasphemy. Ang sabi po nila, wrong is right and right is wrong. Yun po ang modern philosophy po ngayon. At yun po ay binanggit na ng prophet Isaiah sa chapter 5 verse 20 na may mga panahon, kapatid, na sasabihin nila na definitely wrong talaga. Sasabihin nila, that is right. At yung right, sasabihin nila, that is wrong. Okay. Now, so what is significant? Significant is that if you recognize your wrongness, if you are going to realize that you are wrong, that you are not okay, that you have a problem in your life, that is very significant. Okay? Yun dapat ang ating response bilang Kristiyano sa kasalanan. Admit na tayo po ay makasalanan. Admit na tayo po ay still sinning in the sight of God. That is a spiritual response. Okay? Let's go to verse 20. Now, if I do that with that I would not, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. Verse 21, I find then a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. Whenever you do good, okay? Sabi ng Bible, present ang evil. Whenever you do good, present ang evil. Why? Because you have a body that is what? That is full of what? Evil and wickedness. The heart, sabi ng Bible, desperately wicked. Ang puso ng tao, makasalanan, marumi. Okay? That is the flesh. Tell you. I find then a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. For I delight in the law of God after the inward man. But I see another law in my members, warring. Kaya makita natin sa Galatians chapter 5, pag pinag-aral natin yung Galatians chapter 5, makokonnect natin yung Romans sa Galatians. Sabi ng Bible, doon sa Galatians 5, meron pong spiritual warfare din doon, you know? The flesh versus the spirit. 22, for I delight in the law of God after the inward man, that is the new man, but I see another law in my members, warring against the law of my mind, and bringing me into captivity to the law of sin, which is in my members. Okay, malapit na tayo matapos. Okay? Huwag na po kayong bibitaw. Napakaganda po nitong pag-aaral natin ito. You will understand now the two nature in your life. You are saved. You are going to heaven. But you have a problem. Your body is not yet saved. It should be saved because kapag hindi siya na saved, amen, magiging problema yan sa eternity. Kaya nga po may rapture. Rapture will redeem your body. Rapture will change your body. Rapture will save your body. Okay? Verse 24. O wretched man that I am. This is Paul, the greatest Christian who ever lived. Siya po yung gumawa ng maraming mga missions. Sumulat ng 13 epistles. The greatest Christian who ever lived. But he said this, O wretched man that I am. Sa Amazing Grace, makikita din natin yung word na yan, wretched. Ibig sabihin ng wretched, you know, he's a bad man, he's a wretched man. It's a bad situation. Wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from the body of this death? Who shall deliver me? Okay, before we go to last verse, let's open 1 Corinthians 15. Okay, verse number 54. So when the discorruptible shall have put on incorruption, 1 Corinthians 15:54. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So, ang salvation, okay? Ang completeness ng salvation natin is in the time of the rapture. You know why? While we are still living in this world, while we are still living in this body, we have great problem with sin. Kaya nga po, we have to pray, amen, for the rapture. Para maalis na lahat ang problema mo. Kasi ang pinakamahalagang, pinaka-source ng maraming problema sa iyong buhay, actually, is your sin. Okay, we're going to live verse 24. Let's go to verse 25. This is the last verse. Okay, huwag po kayong bibitaw. I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then with the mind, I myself serve the law of God, but with the flesh, the law of sin. See that? You can serve now the law of God. Amen? But you have to consider that in your body is the law of sin. But you can serve God. You can serve God. Even sin is present, evil is present, you can still obey God and you can still serve God. What you have to do is to serve God, serve righteousness, and don't serve unrighteousness. Amen po. Okay. So, in verse 23, ito po yung mga cross-reference. Bibigay ko lang po ito. Take note of this. Romans 6, verse 12 to 16. Psalms 19, 13. No Bible believer teaches that a Christian can live any way he wants. To the contrary, a Christian should live like the Lord wants him to live. And where he does not, he pays for it. It just does not affect his salvation. So may payment pa rin sa ating mga paggawa ng mali. Pero hindi nga lang ito naapektuhan ang ating kaligtasan. Okay? Now verse 24. If a preacher doesn't make you feel mean, he is no good. Sabi ng isang kataga. If a preacher doesn't make you feel mean, he is no good. Ibig sabihin, our preaching should attack the sin of the flesh. Our preaching should be against the sin of the flesh. Sapagkat ang preaching natin, pag, you know, parang ginaganyan lang, ha? Ang tao, I tell you are not helping him. Because there's a problem in his body, there's a problem in his thoughts, there's a problem in his mind, there's a problem in his mouth, there's a problem in his hearing, there's a problem in his seeing, there's a problem in his feelings. I tell you, the preaching that we need in this time is the preaching against our sins. Amen, amen, amen. Alright, so, good morning po sa inyong lahat. I think it's already afternoon. So, salamatan ko lamang po ang mga ating mga tagapakinig. Manalangin muna po tayo. Let's close in prayer. Our Father in Heaven, thank you Lord God for the blessing that we have this morning. And also this afternoon, Lord God, sana po ay bigyan mo ng daan ang another preaching ng Word of God. Lord, tulungan niyo po kami at pagpalain sa aming mga gawain sa maghapon. Lord, i-bless niyo po kami ng protection laban po sa sakit. Lord, marami pong mga namamatay, Panginoong Diyos, but please, protect us, protect our family, protect our churches, protect our nation, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so good morning po, Brother Bal, amen. Sister Raquel, Brother Arnold, Brother John, Brother Mina. Okay, hello ko na. Okay, Sister Julia, Brother Jabez. Okay, si Brother John sa Kamiling, Calum John Ilman, Venus is watching, Gina Lynn Gabriel, Chris Tolentino, Brother Richie, Opi Asio, Jonard Barbosa, Pastor Hani Kua, Pastor Jingo Dison, Rina, happy birthday, Rihanna, Sammy Muralda, Sister Noemi Vergara, Elizabeth Bucalin, Aaron Naboya, OJ, Pastor Arturo Archeta, Ime Sam, Uboy Meneses, Bernadette Villaflor Belen, Sister Risa, Camille Pineda, good morning sister, May Ali, good morning po, Tita Noy, good morning sister, Jam Jam is watching right now, Sister Je, God bless you, Sapinel, God bless po, Brother Urge, Sobre Bilia, amen, amen, Saliana Rose Gonzalez Nicolas, amen, Sapinel, and the rest of the group. God bless po at magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. See you next video. God is good all the time. God is good.